Okay, let us answer this question. But as said, these were the actual questions taken from the test. So the pictures might be blurred. So, but for your reference, I just wrote you the exact question over here, right? Now I'll read out the sentence that is over there in the picture. A number arrangement machine, when given an input line of numbers, rearranges them following a particular rule in each step. The following is an illustration of input and rearrangement. Fine. So this is a input and we have some arrangement that is over happening because of a machine. Now we need to understand the algorithm, what is happening. And then we have to answer the question. Now let us check what is the question. Step 6 is the last step of the arrangement. Fine. So we have step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So totally 6 steps we have as a rearrangement. As per the rules followed in the above steps. So as exactly the same which followed in the above steps. Find out in each of the following questions the appropriate steps for the given input. Fine. So the given input is this one. And we have to find out the questions accordingly, right? Now let us see the very first question on the given input. Which of the following is the first number from the right in step 4? Okay, from the right means our right, right? That too, they are not asking about the step 6. They're asking about only the step 4, right? So it is sufficient if you find out till step 4. But first, we need to know what exactly we need to know. So what exactly happening in between the given steps, right? Now let us try to do that. Input is the given numbers over here. Now, if you observe, what is the process that happened from input to step 1? Just pause the video, try for some time, and then if you haven't got it, or if you got it, just watch the video, you'll understand. I hope you did. Now, I'll just let you know the logic. If you observe from the input to step 1, there are some multiplication happened, right? Now, so the first number in the given series is just multiplied twice. So that it give me 1,34,436. Right now, the second number remains the same, so it is just multiplied one times. Now, the third number is multiplied four times. So, if you observe, you got 3,29,780. Right now, when you multiply this number with what will give you 28 around. Now, 9 threes are 27, so it must be a multiple of 3. If you observe, 3 into 1 is 3. Right now, similarly, you just guess what would be the multiplication number. 6 fours are 24. Right, and 6 9s are 54, so definitely this must be 6. Right, and this one, what about this? 6 2s are 12, but 6 are 36, so it is not 6. Right now, can it be 5? Exactly. Now, 5 6 are 30, 5 2s are 12, but then 5 7s are 35 is there, so 5 2s are 10 plus 3 will give me 13. So, this is the multiplication. What is the multiplication? It's just multiplied with 1 2. 3, 4 and 5, 6. We observe 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6 is the multiplication that happened. Right? That is the input for the step 1. So that is happened from the input to the step 1. Look how typical it is, right? If you don't think properly, you might not get the logic. So it is all about your thinking ability. Right? Now, so coming to the second one, right? That is from step 1 to step 2, what might have happened? If you observe, the numbers are just arranged in an ascending order from the small number to the biggest number, right? If you observe, 23,102 is the smallest number, so which is arranged as the first number. Now, next smallest is 1,34,436. Next smallest is 1,37,000. And then it is 2,55,000, and then 2,82,000, and then 3,29,000. So that is the arrangement. Now, the question is, look, if you observe, there are some very big numbers and suddenly they drop down to a single digit or a two digit number. What would have happened from step 2 to step 3, right? I'm just writing over here. So, ascending order. Okay, ascending order. Now, you tell me what would have happened from step 2 to step 3. Yeah, some of your guesses are true. Now, it is a digital sum. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So, 8 is the digital sum of all these digits we have. Now, similarly, the sum of all these digits is nothing but 21. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 15 plus 6, 21. And so on. If you observe, all these are digital sums. The digital sums of the digits. Right? Now, again, suddenly, a single digit number or a two digit number become a four digit or a five digit number or a six digit number again. Again, how could that be possible? So what would have happened from step 3 to step 4? If you observe, the first two almost are same, right? And sometimes the first three are almost the same, right? What would have given the same exact numbers as the first two or first three? And there is a difference. Exactly. Again, your guesses are true. 102 minus 8, the last three digits of every number minus the digital sum of the previous one will give you 94. 102 minus 8 will give you 94. Similarly, 436 minus 21 will give you 415. 680 minus 25 will give you 655 and so on. So here we have the last three digits, right, minus the digital sum numbers. Right, everybody? That is the logic that happened. Now, from step 4 to step 5, again some two-digit numbers we have everywhere. That too, we are only finding 18, 18, 27, 27, 27, 27. So, what would be the logic? Now, again, just check the digital sum, you'll get the same answer. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 9, 14. 14 plus 4, 18. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 1, 13. 13 plus 1, 18. And so on. You'll get the digital sum over here also. So, this is also a digital sum. But if you observe over here, there is again one last step which happened. Now, actually, till here really it's enough. But what if there are some more questions, as I said, right? As per the rules following the above steps, find the each questions, right? So we might have two or three. So let us find all the steps, right? That might be happened till the last. So let us do that. Now, so you are at the last step. Step 5 to step 6, what would have happened? 1863, 27, 45. Again, all the 27s are given as 45. Now, can I just take this as a consideration without any reason? Definitely not. There might be something that might give you the final step, that is the last step, as it. What would it be? If you observe, 18 into 2 will give you 36 and 36 and reverse. Right? 36 and the number got reversed, so that would give me 63. Similarly, from all these, 27 into 2 will give you 54 and reverse. That will give you 45. Right? I hope you understood the point. So I hope you love the trick a lot. So this is a question from input and output. They'll give you an input and you have to find out an output throughout following some logarithm here. Right? But people tell me, is the question done? No. Look, we have just found out the logic that is happening from the step 1 to step 2, step 2 to step 3 and so on till step 6. But what about our question? The actual question is somewhere over here. Right? There are certain numbers where we have to find out. Look, again, as said, there might be multiple questions. So even though it takes some time, so definitely you are going to get two or three questions on this for sure. So these 2 or 3 minutes over here will help you a lot. So, right? So let us move on to the actual question now. Now, for your reference, I gave the same numbers on the other side. If you want to just have a look, you can. Right? 18424 34168. 18424 34168 and so on. If you observe the same I have written, you can take a screenshot and check with my numbers. Okay. So again, look, can I follow any other approach? No, I have to follow the same. Why? Because the given, right? As per the rules followed in the above steps, find out in each of the following questions. So I have to follow the same rules. Now, what is the rule we have? So from input to step 1, I have a multiplication of into 1, into 2, into 3, into 4, into 5, and into 6. So that's how it followed the process. No. Now, so 18424 into 2 will give me what? Look, any number double, it's very easy, right? So that would give me 36,848, right? Now, one time, so that would give me 34,168. Now, four times is a bit difficult, but still, you can do it. Now, do it and tell me what would be the answer very quick, right? I'm just writing out the number. It will be 374,992. Now, so again, multiplication of 12,284 into 3 will give you 36,852. So multiplying this number into 6 will give you 115,524, right? Now, last but not the least, so 25,680 into 5 will give you 128,400. So from input to the step 1, you know what had happened, right? It is just a multiplication of numbers. But step 1 to step 2, what happened? Exactly, the ascending order happened. The ascending order. Now, what is the ascending order? So, the first number is, if you observe, the first least number is 34,168. Right, this number. And then the next number is 36,848. And then the next list is 36,852. Right now, next list will be 1,15,524. Next list 1,28,400, and then the highest would be 3,74,992. Right now, you know what happened from step two to step three. Look, now it's very simple because you already know the logic, or you already know the logarithm. Right now, what is the next logarithm? Exactly, the digital sum. So, what is the digital sum? The digital sum of this number, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 6, 14, 14 plus 8, that will give you 22. If you observe, so just let me know the digital sum of every numbers, right? This would be 29, this would be 24, this would be 18, this would be 15, and this would be 34, right? Now, you know what happens from the step 3 to step 4. Actually, I'm just stopping over here. Why? Because the question is regarding step 4 only, right? You don't waste your time by going through the next steps. If you have any more questions, then only you can get it, right? Now, so as they have asked only till like step 4, I'm just doing till step 4. Now, you know what happens from the step 3 to step 4, right? Now, step 2 numbers, the last three digits minus the digital sum, right? That will give you the answer. So, 34,146. Now, similarly, the other numbers would be 36,819. Now, the next number is 36,828. The following number, 1,15,506. Now, the upcoming number, 1,28,385. Last but not the least, 3,74,958. So, that would be the last three digits minus the subtraction of the digital sum we have. Right? Now, so this is the number we have. Now, what is the question? Our question is, in the step 4, from the right, what is our first number? So, in the step 4, this is the step 4. So, from the right, right means what? Our right only. So, this is right and this is left. Right? So, what is the first number? It is 3,74,958 is the answer for the very first question. Right? I hope you understood this question a lot and you enjoyed this question a lot. Right, everybody? Okay, let us try to answer the question. Which figure completes the statement? Now, what is the statement? The first figure is 2, the other figure. So, these two are a pair. As the below second figure is 2 what? Now, I have to find the figure which has the same relation as like the previous one. Now, just pause the video and try to answer on your own. If you are done, just watch the video. Now, I hope you have at least guessed some answer. Right? Now, let me tell you what is the relation between the first two given figures actually. Right now we have a rectangle shape, and then let me say these are two wings kind of, and then we have a final figure where we have a same rectangle as like inside one, right? And then we have two such figures over here, right, everybody? Now, can I just say the relation between them is, now let me say these are two wings, right? So the first wing gets folded. Now the first wing gets folded, and what happens, right? Now, it will be the same. And then when it gets folded, as in when it just turns the other side, it will be in this way. Can I say that or not? Yes or no, everybody? Yes or no? Exactly. That I can say. Now, in the same way, the second step. So, this is the first fold I can say. And when folded the second fold, what I'll get? Again, a rectangle inside. And already there was a shape inside. And when this is folded back into it, now it exactly looks like a mirror image of this. Right, everybody? So, this I can say the final output of the given initial figure. So, just the outside wings got folded inside. So, that gave me the final output. Similarly, I have to just apply the same strategy over to the second figure. So, here I have a rectangle inside again, and then two shaded parts next to them, right? Two shaded parts. I'm just representing these as a shaded parts. Now, again, what is the first step? The first step is one of the wing gets folded. So, then what happens? When the shaded part is on top of the normal part, it will be exactly looking like a shaded part again. Now, where I'll have the other wing? Exactly, I'll have the other wing on the left-hand side because the right-hand one got folded, as I am thinking, okay? Or you can think the left-hand side can get folded as the first, right? Or both at the same time. But for detailed information, I'm just folding one by one, right? So, this is the first fold. Now, once the second fold is done, right? However, this also will be shaded part. This will be this and this will be the shaded part, right? Now, when the second fold is also done, right? When the second fold is also done, Now we'll have a rectangle which is completely shaded, right? Both on top of it. So that will be my option C if I'm not wrong. So that is the answer for this question, everybody. I hope you understood this question a lot. If not, just watch the part. Let us answer one more question on the diagrammatic reasoning part. Identify the odd one out figure from A, B, C, and D given. Fine, we have four figures and one would be different from the other three. So that is says odd one out. Now you find out what is odd one out and just guess the answer. I hope you did. Now, if you observe the very first figure, let us try to first try to understand the inside of the triangles we have. Right now, B, D, F, M, O, Q, G, I, K, S, U, W. These are like near to each other, right? If you observe B, C is missed, D, E is missed. Right, everybody? Now, so B, C, D, E, F. So one alphabet is getting missed in between. Right? Now, next. Coming here, M, N is missed, O, P is missed. G, H is missed, I, J is missed. Yes, T is missed, U, V is missed. So inside, do we have any differences, everybody? No, everything is same over here, right? So B, D, F. So where we have a missing of C and where we have a missing of E, right? Now, similarly, the others. Inside, we have no differences that we can find out as a, one is odd number. Now, let us come to the outside figures we have, right? Let me just erase the unwanted part over here. Now, coming to the outside figures, if you observe, A, D, G. A is 1, D is 4, and G is 7, right? Now, if you observe, there is a difference of common difference each. 1 to 4, we have a common difference of 3. 4 to 7, again, we have a common difference of 3. Similarly, T is 20, W is 23. So, here, again, we have a common difference of 3. Now, Z is 26, so again, we have a common difference of 3. Similarly, E is 5, H is 8, so we have a common difference of 3. Now, J is 10. Now, tell me, 8 to 10, how much is the difference, everybody? The difference is 2, right? I can say the difference here is 2, whereas the others, we have 3, 3, 3. Now, let me find out the other one also. Now, so here I have K, which is 11, N, which is 14. Again, I have a difference of 3. Now, Q is 17. Again, I have a common difference of 3. So, everywhere I have a common difference where 2 is not a common difference here. So, that says C is my option for this question, right? I hope you understood this question a lot, which gave you a detailed information regarding the odd one out figures, right, everybody? Let us answer the last question. Consider the input and information provided below. Fine. The input is ankle and I have written over here. There are four certain symbols which has four different statements of their own. So the first symbol says jump each character by plus two character positions. Now, what is plus two character positions? For example, first of all, you should know what are the character positions. A has a character position of 1. B has a character position of exactly 2. Now, Z, if I ask you, we have 26 alphabets. So Z will be the 26th alphabet. Now, similarly, if I ask you N, N will be the 14th alphabet. So that are the character positions of that. So you need to know the character positions, then only you can answer this question very easily, right? Now, so we have to just go accordingly to the given statements. If the sequence of this sequence applied for the input, what is the output? Fine. So we have to pick one of the possible output over here to this input. So the input is this. Now, let me just do the very first process. What is the first process? This is over the symbol over here, the first symbol. Now, this symbol defines vowels shift by plus two positions. That means how many vowels are here? Only two vowels. First vowel, second vowel. Now, first of all, let us give the alphabetical values. A is 1, N is 14, K is 11, L is 12, and E is 5. So, vowels will be shifted by plus two. So, plus two means plus two and plus two. And then the other characters, that means the consonants by plus one. So, the consonants must be by plus one. So that gives you what as the first step, step one. The step one will be 1 plus 2 will be 3. What is 3? It will be C. 14 plus 1, 15. 15 will be O. 11 plus 1, 12. 12 will be L. 13, it's M. 7, it's G. Right? So this is the first step I got from the input. Right? Now, coming up to the second one. What is the second one? Right? The first figure. The first figure says, jump each character by plus two character positions. Now, each character by plus two means now 1, 15, 12, 13, and 7. So every character by plus 2. That is what the symbol defines. Right? So plus 2 everywhere. That I can see. So that gives me 1 plus 2, 3. Sorry, C is 3. So 3 plus 2, 5. 5 is E. 17. 17 is Q. 14. 14 is N. 15 is O. 9 is I. So these are the characters that I'm going to get after the plus 2 addition. Right? Now the third symbol says mu. So what is the third symbol says? It says shift the character in the increasing order. Like the first character is plus 1. Second character plus 2. Third character plus 3 and so on. So first of all, E is 5, Q is 17, N is 14, 15 and 9. So here I should do what? So after applying the mu symbol over here, so that gives me plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4 and plus 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 is F. Here comes 19. 19 is yes. 17, 17 is Q. 19, 19 is again yes. 14, 14 is N. Right? Now, so after the mu, we have one more symbol over here. Now, so this symbol says again, as like the first one, vowels by plus 2, consonants by plus 1. Now, unfortunately, we have all the consonants only. So, all just by plus 1. So, first of all, character values, 6, 19, 17, 19, 14. Right? Now, so all plus 1, that gives me what? 7. 7 means G. 20. 20 means T. 18, 18 is R, 20, 20 is again T, 15, 15 is O. Now the last step, that is, right? Now, so what this is, this says, retain middle character in the same position. Fine, I have to retain the same position, the middle character. Now, and other character step back by one position. Now, step back by one position means what? Now, all the other will be just minus 1. So, 20, 20 and 15. So here, 2 minus 1 and these 2 minus 1. Now, 7 minus 1, 6. 6 is F. 20 minus 1, 19. 19 is yes. Now, F, F, R. The only option is option B. That should be my answer, but let me check. 20 minus 1, 19. 19 is yes. 15 minus 1, 14. 14 is yes. This is the last step of the entire input that is given. Okay. So, or is called as an output. Last step or an output. So, what is the question? Which is the output? So the output is nothing but option B, FSR, SN. I hope you understood better, right? This is again one more question I can say from input and output kind of concept, right everybody? So thank you for watching the video till the end. If you have liked the video, don't forget to press the like button. Also join our social media handles like Telegram group, Instagram page and WhatsApp group. Links to all these handles are given in the description. Thank you guys.